Thinking about adding a thermostat to your smart home automation setup? Today I'm going to replace my thermostat with the Ecobee3 smart Wi-Fi thermostat. And in my home, I have a special circumstance in that I only have four wires that go from my existing thermostat over to my mechanical closet. So in addition to the Ecobee3 setup and review, we'll also be installing the power extender kit. So stay tuned. Hi again, John Stone, the DIY smart home guy. If you watched my starting your smart home video, you'll remember that I mentioned energy savings as one of the five main categories of home automation. In fact, many people choose to replace thermostats early in their smart home journey since, if done correctly, it can provide significant energy savings. According to the U.S. Energy Information Administration, 40% of all energy consumption in 2015 went to heating and cooling. So, a properly configured smart thermostat is a must-have if you want to reduce your energy bill. Save the planet, save the ozone, save polar bears, ice caps, the oceans, the flowers, the clownfish, the staghorn coral, the penguins, the whales, the salmon, the caribou, the oxen, the seabirds, high elevation tree possums, American pika, which is basically a cross between a squirrel and a rabbit, butterflies, and frogs. Now me, I'm mostly interested in staying comfortable and saving money. But, you know, the other stuff is important too. Most of the stuff a smart thermostat can do is possible with a digital thermostat with the scheduling capability. But many people don't bother to set up the schedules due to the complexity. And the schedule keeps on trucking even if you're out of the house for an extended period of time. In my case, I want the ability to control the temperature remotely. There are a few times when we are away from the house for a few days, and I'd like the ability to tell the house when I'm coming home so that the temperature has returned to normal by the time I arrive. There are a variety of smart thermostats out there, including the Nest, Honeywell, Ecobee, and a few others. Due to a pre-existing wiring condition in my home, my options are somewhat limited. The problem is that I only have four control wires between my existing thermostat and my HVAC unit. My original plan was to install the Honeywell smart Wi-Fi thermostat because a few months ago I helped my dad install the Honeywell unit into his home, and I was pretty impressed. The Honeywell thermostat installation was very straightforward and we had it installed in under 30 minutes. The app was very intuitive and the setup was a breeze, so I was sold early on. The only drawback that my parents experienced was with the anticipation or recovery feature. Basically, it's a feature that pre-warms or pre-cools the house to the expected temperature before the scheduled start time. Since they have a multi-zone system, it was creating problems with the schedules on the not-so-smart thermostats in the other zones. The solution was simple. They turned the recovery feature off and everything seemed to work fine. We did connect it to their Amazon Echo Dot, and from what I hear, the Amazon Echo is the star of pretty much every party they have when there's friends over. According to my research, the Honeywell unit requires a C wire, and since I have both the furnace and air conditioner, this means I need five wires. And as I said, my wire harness only has four. So I needed an alternative, and after a bit of research, I settled on the Ecobee3. The option I purchased came with the Ecobee3 smart programmable Wi-Fi thermostat and one remote sensor. Both are visible as soon as you open the box. There are other options like a light version, which comes with no sensors, and another which ships with three sensors. There's a little device called a power extender kit, also known as a PEK, and it's located under the top panel and sits alongside the sensor mount and the mounting hardware. The sensor mount is a little plastic stand that provides you with additional mounting options. The PEK installs on the mechanical side of the system and makes it so that you can use the Ecobee without the C wire, which is perfect given my four wire situation. Don't throw the box away just yet. If you lift the lower panel, you'll see the additional mounting plate and the instruction guides. The instruction manual is very comprehensive and it really helped me when I was trying to install this thermostat. The remote sensor is a multi-purpose sensor detecting both temperature and motion. If you use the full features of the sensor, it'll calculate the average temperature of the thermostat and all the other Ecobee sensors to try to balance out the temperature in your house. According to the app, the Follow Me feature will average out the temperature only in the rooms that recently detected motion. I already have two more sensors on order, and it's my understanding you can add up to 32, but I'm guessing 3 is going to be enough for my house. Now, like most homes, my house has both hot and cold spots, especially at night when the doors are closed. The master bedroom tends to run a little hot, so as you guessed, the first sensors that I'm going to be putting in are going to be in the bedroom, and that should help me regulate the temperature, and that should save us money, and that'll help us get a good night's sleep. Since this is a Wi-Fi thermostat, we'll also have the capability to control it from our phone. This has got to be a feature you'd really like. We can turn the temp down while out of town, and then back up several hours before we plan to be home. Again, save money, sleep good. And of course, this won't be totally cool unless we can control it from our Amazon Echo. Can't let my dad and his friends have one up on me. Can I, Dad? There are a couple of other features worth mentioning. One is the way that the mode changes on the display when you approach. It's nice that it wakes up and provides more information than the standard sleep mode. The other feature I like is the live weather function. This feature is available by just tapping this bottom down here, and the unit displays the forecast and the current temp outside. The Ecobee3 is compatible with most major hubs, including Apple HomeKit, Samsung SmartThings, and the Wink Hub. So what do you say we go get this Ecobee3 installed into a house with no C-wire? I'm going to keep it lighter than normal in this video. We're going to keep it pretty high level. I've left a link to a great Ecobee3 with PEK installation video in the description below. So when we open up my existing thermostat, you'll see that this is a digital unit that only uses two wires. Over in my mechanical closet, there's a converter box that acts almost exactly like the PEK. So I'm going to need to install the PEK where the old converter box sits. Now the reason I only have four wires is that originally this house did not have an AC unit. When the previous owner upgraded and added in the AC, they used this adapter to solve the same problem I'm facing. As usual, before working on any electrical equipment, be sure to shut off the breaker. Most heating and cooling systems have more than one, so please pay close attention. For the installation, we're going to start with the PEK. And before you do anything, I suggest you take pictures of your wiring. Make sure the images are clear just in case you need to refer back to them. I'm going to use these little low voltage connectors to hook in the PEK. So on the PEK side, you can see where I have just four wires coming out of the wall. These are what go up to the thermostat. And we have the red, green, yellow, white. I'm just using that blue as the green, and I went ahead and marked that. So anybody in the future will know what that's supposed to be. So not a big deal there. These just slide right in. If you want to take them out, you can just push on these. Then the other side of the PEK, the wires are already in there. They're already marked. Once you have all your wires in there, you can just snap this in, and that's good. So you also see that I have two bundles here. One is a two wire and one is a three wire. These go across and over and then up into the unit. So it's important when you're doing this that you make sure that you look at those wires and map them out. Now everything should always be marked pretty well on your circuit board. If you notice, I got quite a few terminals here, but so in the end I just looked at, I have a three wire bundle over here, and that corresponds to this three wire bundle over here. And then I marked all those wires using the included wire tags just to make sure that I had everything hooked up correctly. Now the other thing I want to point out is, if you have an external air conditioner like I do, this is that add-on that I mentioned earlier, you have two wires that go off to your HVAC. Those are going to hook into your Y and your common. Now you don't have to do anything with those. Leave those there, make sure those stay hooked up. The only ones that you have to worry about are these. Now normally people are going to tell you that you want to put that PEK inside here. You can see in my case where I couldn't, I would have had to run new wires. So that's okay, as long as you directly translate the five wires that come out of the PEK to the five wires that go into your terminal block inside your furnace, you're fine. And again, don't worry about the wires that go out there. Make sure those stay hooked up on the Y and the C. Let's go over to the thermostat. The installation video that I mentioned earlier goes into a lot more detail about this topic. Again, I suggest you go and watch that. So the thermostat that I'm removing is quite a bit larger than the Ecobee that I'm installing, so I'm clearly not going to be able to use the default mount that comes with the Ecobee. So I'll be using the larger wall plate that I showed earlier in the video that was in the bottom of the box. And because of the location of the hole that the wires come out of in the wall, I have to adjust my wall plate down a little bit more than I'd like to. That means that the outline from the previous thermostat is going to be visible. So after I'm all done, I'm going to need to do some touch-up work. So we finished installing the mount, and then it's time for the wires. The wires that run from the thermostat over to the mechanical closet, the colors match up exactly with the terminals, except for I have a blue wire and the thermostat wants a green wire. So it's no problem, I'm just going to use that blue wire as a green. I don't think it'll be too difficult for me to remember what I did. Now before we install that thermostat, we're going to double check the wires. We're going to triple check the wires. Check those wires several times before you get everything hooked up and turn the breaker back on.
After you get the power on, you'll see the little Ecobee bug. It'll be on just kind of bright. You'll try to touch it, but nothing's going to happen. And after a little bit of time, that Ecobee bug will come on a little bit brighter. At that point, you're going to get a setup screen. This is going to ask you a bunch of questions about how your HVAC system is set up. You're going to want to take the time to read these carefully and make sure you understand, because this is important to how the Ecobee will function. There are quite a few questions, so this process isn't a fast one, but it's worthwhile.
Okay, now that you have the thermostat all up and online, everything should be good to go there. take some time, read the manual, and just figure out how you want to have your settings. We're going to run through the app real quick. So one thing I like, it's a very clean interface right here on the iPhone app. Now when we go into the menu, there's a number of things you can do. On the sensors, this is a nice way that you can see the difference in the temperature between the various rooms. Now, as I said before, I have two more on order. That'll help me balance this out quite a bit. But you can see some of the hot and cold spots that I have within my house, being the 73, 77 degrees. Now, the other thing I like about this is you can create as many schedule zones that you'd like. If you want to make a schedule that has everything behaving differently every hour, you can do that with the Ecobee, which is very nice. It's also, if you see this copy function down at the bottom, it's very easy to copy schedules from one day to the other. That's actually very nice as well. Now the comfort settings is where you're going to want to spend some time. And this is the home, away, and sleep. And from here you can actually say which sensors you want to participate in this particular activity. So for example, at night I can say I don't care what's happening anywhere else in the house. I want to keep my bedroom at this temperature. Ignore every other sensor that I might have. So now let's go get this hooked up with the Amazon Echo. Gonna cut this out so it doesn't matter that I'm being stupid. Okay, so just as we would do in anything else, if you haven't watched any other videos, I go into how to set things up with Alexa all the time. So we'll go very quickly here. You're gonna go into skills, search for Ecobee, and you'll see that Ecobee skill right there. I already have it installed, so I don't need to get it in there. So now if you go over to your smart home, you should see that Ecobee skill in your smart home. All right, now from here, again, this is where you do discover devices. You're gonna do this every time you add in a new skill or a new device. You're gonna wanna make sure you do discover devices. So the first thing I'm gonna do right now is I'm just gonna say, I'm gonna tell Alexa that I want my thermostat to go down to, say, 75 degrees. So let's do that. Computer, set thermostat to 75 degrees. So now you have voice control with the Amazon Echo. You have your app, always good there. Now let's go hook this into the Wink Hub. We're gonna go into add a product. Heating and cooling. And we'll see that Ecobee3 right there. Okay, so now that I have this inside the Wink Hub, the thermostat is brought in, that high and that low. Remember, we just changed that with our voice. I also have full control over auto, fans, heat and cool. I can set my home and away from here. Now one thing I really like about this inside the Wink Hub is I have all of those controls right here at my fingertips. They're kind of disconnected inside the Ecobee app, but inside the Wink Hub everything's all nice and together. So that's very cool. So there's that thermostat off my main screen. If I go into the sensors, it has also brought in the additional sensors that I'm getting out of the Ecobee, for example. So there's my temperature sensors. Now this has brought in the Ecobee thermostat sensors, but as you see here, I have every sensor now inside my Wink Hub. So any robots, anything I can do through Stringify, everything I can now do through my Wink Hub. Also have the humidity sensor, very cool. Okay, and last but not least, let's go get this thing hooked into SmartThings. All right, so let's go add a thing. We're gonna wanna add a device manually, and we're going to add the Ecobee3. And just like we had to do over on the Wink side, we're gonna need to add in our credentials for connecting over to the Ecobee. Okay, so you can see here in the SmartThings app that, again, my bedroom is at 74, my thermostat is set at, or my thermostat is reading 76 degrees, and here you go. So again, I have pretty much everything right there at my fingertips. This is gonna be personal preference, but I actually like the way this displays itself over on the Wink Hub a little bit better. So here's the Wink look and feel. And here's the SmartThings look and feel. And I'm punching around right now to see if I can change anything. Off heat. So on SmartThings, it just is going to toggle through those. If we go over to the Wink Hub side, it's It's got the refresh. Here I can independently change that high-low threshold that it picks up from the Ecobee app. So I would say here, this is a little bit nicer. It's a lot easier for me to control. And I can just set my home or my away. Personally like the Wink Hub interface to the Ecobee a little bit better than the Smart Things, but if you already have Smart Things, there's no problem there.
It's also worth pointing out that Ecobee has a very nice portal. The portal has all of the features that are available from the thermostat and the app, which is pretty nice. Most smart home manufacturers are limiting their apps to the mobile devices. While most of us have smartphones, sometimes I like to work with the bigger screen.
Right, so last thing is we're gonna go into the portal a little bit. Again, the interface is essentially the same as what you would see there on your phone app, but you have the temperature, nice access to all the controls. Same where you can look at that live weather, pretty cool. But all the settings that you have when you were looking at the app or off the thermostat are available here in the PC. You can go in and look at the sensors, again, giving you the variance in the temperatures between the sensors that are installed. And again, looking at it, trying to shoot into the middle of what's going on there.
Some people that I talked to have claimed that they have seen a 20% energy reduction when comparing their energy bill to the previous year. This number sounds a bit big to me. Basically means that the HVAC unit would be running about 50% less. So my guess is that there's other weather-related factors that are involved. But I do believe this unit will pay for itself fairly quickly, probably in a little over a year. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and don't forget to click like. Over here are a couple of other videos that you might enjoy. For more reviews, tips, and DIY videos, visit azhb.com. And thanks to all of you that already follow me over on Facebook or Twitter. Both are at DIY Smart Home Guy. Until next time, cheers.